We continue to work with the American administration, with a lot of people in Congress who do feel, rightly, that these tariffs are hurting American workers like they are hurting Canadian workers and Canadian industry. The president has stuck to his approach on tariffs, even though it's hurting the American people as well. But we know that in this ratification process, there are a lot of strong voices within Congress and across the business community in the United States that recognizes that putting up barriers, particularly barriers based on national security, that are hurting workers in the United States and communities across the United States is not something that we need to do. We're going to keep working to stand up for our steel and aluminum workers.
We've received literally hundreds of submissions crossing a wide variety of programs that have been set up to assist Canadians in this regard, over $2 billion worth. Obviously, because of the large number, there's a certain amount of time to prioritize them and to get the money out the door. I'm very confident that process is unrolling the way it should.
There's no big charm offensive like there was in the early days?
Well, there's a good argument to be made that Canadians are always charming, but there's no overemphasis on that skill down in the United States.
You know, they've collected $1 billion in tariffs. That money should be distributed, not brought into general revenues in order to for them to have other projects that will be coming up in the budget next year. People are hurting because of the tariffs that have been put on by the U.S. and the tariffs that Canadians have put on their own products. And that money that's set aside should really go to the people who are in pain.